Hi kids, good morning. How are you? I hope you are all well and good. Today we are going to see grade 4 science. In that unit 3, human body and need. In that fifth lesson, our food and its digestion. Okay children, already we have discussed about nutrients in food, carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals, balanced diet, different food requirement, digestion of food, preservation of food. Okay children, today rest of the lesson we can discuss. First is the care of cooked food. What is that? Care of cooked food. Uncovered cooked food gathers germs and dust. So we should keep our food always covered. Okay children, in your kitchen after cooking, what did the mother do? Yes, she will close the cooked food with some plates, isn't it? Yes. Why she was covering the food with the plate? Because if it's open, some germs will be covered and insects would fall down in the food, isn't it? Yes. So she will cover the cooked food with the plate. Next is that half cooked food is hard to chew and digest. So the food should be cooked properly for the sufficient time so that it is soft enough to eat and digest. Okay children, will you eat half cooked food? No, because it will be hard to chew and digest. So we must cook our food properly. Next, cooked food or ripened fruits left open for longer duration will be spoiled by germs. The cooked food or ripened fruits left open means it will be spoiled by germs. So to avoid spoilage, we have different methods to preserve the food. Okay children, the food we are eating every day is not ready-made food from nature. Nature provides with raw vegetables, fruits and food grains. We buy them from the market, bring them home, cook and eat. When the food is in excess, we usually put in refrigerators. This type of saving the food is known as food preservation. If you leave them outside, the food will be spoiled. Children, if we need vegetables and fruits, means what we do? Yes, we go to the market and buy and come, isn't it? Yes, that vegetables will be cooked in our home. After eating the food, if the food have excess, what we do? Yes, we keep it in our refrigerators. Otherwise, it will be spoiled. So, this keeping the excess food in refrigerators is called food preservation. Okay, children, have different methods of preservation. We can see one by one. Methods of preservation of food. First is the refrigeration. What is that? Refrigeration. Germs do not grow at low temperature. Foodstuffs like milk, bread, vegetables, eggs, fruits and cooked food can be preserved by keeping them in refrigerator. Okay, if you have a excess food or fruits or vegetables, means it will keep it in out, means it will be spoiled quickly. So we can store in our refrigerators. Okay children, by canning, some foodstuffs can be stored in airtight containers. Bacteria and other germs cannot grow in them as they do not get air and moisture. Fruits, fish, meat and sweets are canned for preservation. In your kitchen, have you seen containers, children? mother kept in the shelves. Yes, if the foodstuffs can be stored in that air containers, bacteria cannot grow in that container. So fruits, fish, meat and sweets are canned for preservation. Okay, next is the boiling. What is that? Boiling. Boiling at very high temperature kills germs. Boiling helps in preserving liquid foods like milk. Okay, boiling at very high temperature kills the germs. So it can preserve our foods. Drying. Drying means some vegetables like carrot, peas, cauliflower, etc. are dried and preserved and are used in off season. When the foodstuff is dried, bacteria and other germs cannot grow as there is no moisture. In this way, foodstuff can be saved from spoilage. Okay, children, some vegetables like carrot, cauliflower, peas, etc. are dried and preserved and are used in off of the seasons. Okay, when this foodstuff is dried, that bacteria and other germs cannot grow in that area. So, as there is no moisture. Next is the pickling. What is that? Pickling. Food can be stored by adding certain chemicals known as preservatives. What is that? Food can be stored by adding certain chemicals, using the chemicals known as preservatives. A commonly used preservative is salt, and oil are used for making pickles with vegetables like cauliflower, raw mango, tomato, lemon, etc. Vinegar is also used to preserve some pickles. Okay, children, have you seen pickles in your home? Yes, some children like the pickles with curd rice, isn't it? Yes, that pickles are adding of salt and oil, isn't it? We can have different types of pickles, cauliflower, raw mango, tomato, lemon, like that. In that pickles, we can add vinegar also because it will be preserved some pickles from the germs. So it will preserve long time. Next is by making jams. Most of the fruits can be made into jams by adding sugar. Excess sugar is also good preservative like salt. Microbes cannot grow in jams because of excess sugar. In jams have lots of sugar. Like salt also, it is also a good preservative. So microbes cannot grow in the jams because of excess sugar. Okay, children, next is the junk food. Already we have discussed about junk food. Once again, I am repeating that not to eat junk foods, children. Avoid foods in covered plastic packets. Okay, junk food. Do you know what is junk food? Yes, it is ready-made food available in the market, which has very low nutritive value. This junk food contains so many chemicals to give colors and flavoring agents. Flavoring agents means for smell. All these chemicals can harm your body. So chips and some fried things are usually fried in very cheap oils, which are harmful. So it is good to avoid such food. Okay, children, we want to avoid junk foods. Okay, you can see in this picture some of the junk foods, isn't it? Yes, cake, sandwich, pizza, toffees, chips, like that. So you want to avoid those foods, those junk food. You cannot take it. Okay, we can see quick scroll. Food is the basic requirement for all living things. The food we eat contains nutrients such as carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals. Water and roughage are also important for our body to do many functions. Cooking makes food tasty, soft and appetizing and also helps in proper digestion. Cooking improves the quality of food and kills the germs. We also eat some raw food which has to be washed and cleaned before eating. Always wash the vegetables before cutting but not after cutting. To avoid the wastage of food and spoilage by microbes, we store the food in refrigerator. We also can save the food by canning or pickling. Okay, we can see keywords. Nutrients. What is the meaning of nutrients? Substances which are present in our food and help in the growth of our body. Balanced diet. A diet that provides us with all the nutrients needed in correct proportion to keep our body healthy. Protective food. They are minerals and vitamins which protect us from diseases. Preservation. Saving food from getting spoiled. Refrigeration. Storage of food at low temperature. Digestion. Process of breaking down of food in body. Enzymes. Chemicals of our body which helps in body reactions like digestion. Okay children, today we can see some new words. First one, germs. Food preservation. Refrigeration. Boiling. Drying. Pickling. Junk food. Bacteria. Okay children, we can move to our homework session. Today's homework is revise the lesson fully. Write new words 2 times and read. Read methods of preservation of food. Refer page number 41. Okay children, you can see in this picture. This picture is in your book, page number 44. You can write the parts name. Use pencil children, write neatly and send it to me. Okay children, we will meet in next class. Thank you.